Today's GrandMA3 tutorial is going to be about recipes. Recipes is something new GrandMA3 introduced in their latest software. Recipes is extremely powerful if you are a touring technician. If you need to introduce new fixtures to your show, if you need to reduce the amount of fixtures to your show, and you still want all your effects to work as they usually do. We're going to take a look at recipes in cues, which is very, very powerful. So let's get into it. As you can see here, I built a small show. We have a few colors up here. We have some intensity. We have a group of Astra 600 IP fixtures, and we have a single position here. So if we want to look at recipes in this one here, we have our main cue list with all our colors in it. And to be able to build a recipe from that, we need to change the view just a little bit. So if you go into the MA button up here in the settings and we go into mask, you can say show recipes down here. If you click that, you can see something appeared down here. If you go into a queue, you can see the queue is completely empty. There's nothing in it, but we can go down here into the new recipe and right click, and we can see there's a new command line coming up here. You can scroll back and forth, and we have a selection and we have a value. So let's start here. We have a selection. If we right click here, you can simply select one of your groups. Let's just select the Astra 600, and the value in this case is going to be dimmer. So now we put something in the queue without actually storing it into the queue. We simply put a reference in from our dimmer preset. So let's see if we go this one, you can see they're now turned on over here. Q1 is active. So we need something else in Q1 because this is not enough. We need the preset as well. So we say new recipe, it makes a new line down here. And we right click and say we want our Astras again. And we right click and say we want a position and we want preset number one. So as soon as I select preset number one, the lights, the fixtures go into preset number one. So this is Q1, which is basically just two lines of recipe. I think we need to add one more line. We need to add a color as well. So if we see, we can make a little bit more room here, like this. And we go back into Q1 and say, what else do we need? We need a new recipe line, we need the group, and we need a color preset down here. Let's just select the white one. Can't see any change right now because of course it's white already. So let's go into queue number two and build a new recipe. We take the selection again, the Astras. The value is just color this time because the fixtures are already on. So if we go into queue number two, we now see it changing color. I'm just going to do all of them down here with all the colors I have in my presets, and I'm going to speed the video up a little bit so you don't have to wait for it. So now I made the entire sequence and we can just have a look at it. If I tap through all the colors here, I simply can go through it. And I didn't save anything into the sequence at all. I simply put references into the different recipes in here. And by the way, if you haven't joined our email list yet for our new online school, just do that. There's a link down there in the description. Sign up for our email list and I will email you once in a while with news and updates. And you can unsubscribe anytime, so there's no foul in doing so. So now we're going to make a fun effect. And before we do that, the color bump effect like we did in the two videos ago, let's store that into a recipe preset instead of storing the recipe directly into the queue. So let's build an empty preset here. If we say store a preset, we say edit settings. We can make a new recipe with the Astras and we can put them in the color of white and we can delay them from 0 to 0.5 seconds and maybe just for the fun of it, just give it a wing of 2. And the next one, we go into the settings here again and we build a recipe again because we need to take the color out as well. So we go into color and we go into color off. Once again, we say delay from 0 to 0.5 and we still need a wing of 2. So now we have a preset down here, a recipe preset. If I double click it, you can see what it does and the same if I double click the other one. So let's reference that into our bump cue list over here. So in Q1, we can simply say new recipe, all our Astras, and we can go into the effect down here and choose the white one and the queue number two. Oops, we need to delete this one, sorry. And we go into all our asterisks again, we go into effect and we take the color off. And we just built them with a delay time and a wing. So if I go this one up here now, it's gonna put it in, it's gonna take it out, which is really, really cool. And here comes the really, really cool part. We're gonna add some new fixtures into the show, fixtures that are not even patched yet, and within minutes they're gonna do exactly the same as these ones. And by the way, if you're not on our Discord server, you can do so. There's a link down there in the description. It's absolutely free. We're building a community in there, helping each other out. There's a lot of newbies in there. And if you're a newbie, good place to ask questions. If you are an experienced GrandMA3 user, please come in there and maybe you can help some other people learning GrandMA3. So let's get on with it. Let's just clear everything here. Let's go into our patch and say we need 24 new fixtures. We go into new fixture, we select Martin here, we go into MacViber profile in 16-bit and we select them right here. We say we need 24 of them, we call them 801 and we patch them on universe 2 number 1 and we create. And now you can see we have 24 Vipers down here, and the Vipers have not been in the show before, so basically they know nothing about what's happening in our show right now. So what we can do now is we just need to set them up in 3D, 801 through 824, please. And we go into setup, we put them up in the air somewhere, and we align them like this. Now there we go. So they know nothing because they haven't been in the show before. So there's a few things we need to fix, basically just one thing. We need to give it a position. This is a universal preset and these are universal presets. So they already work in color. They already work in intensity. So right now we basically just need to give it a color to integrate it into this preset here. So if we go into position and we just put them up in the air like this and maybe fan them out a little bit because we can. And then we store this into our preset, we merge, and we clear everything. But they're still not in our show because we need to put them into the group we just used. We have the Astro group, and we need to add them into the Astro group. So if I take, once again, 801 through 824, we just make a group up here. We need to store it into a group up here like this. We just label it to be sure that we remember what it is. All Vipers, like this, and we clear. So now we can take all our Vipers and we can store them into our Astro group and we can merge, and whoopty, now they're in the show. Now you can do exactly the same as before. They are introduced into the show and we didn't really do anything, we just stored it into the group. And there's one more little thing you need to know about this, because if I run my effect, you can see they run kind of weird. So we need to fix the selection grid. So if I clear everything here and I reset my selection grid, I select all the group here or the entire group, and I know I have 12 fixtures in the first row and I have 24 fixtures introduced as a new one. So if I select the little, you see the little blue dot here, we need to move the little blue dot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 here, and we select all our Vipers and they're gonna align pretty good here, and we store this into our Astro group and we merge it. The Astro group is now gonna remember this selection. So if we clear everything here and we run our effect, you can see now everything is still working and we didn't do any programming at all. It's only working because of references to recipe presets. So that's the power of recipes. If you like the video, give it a like. It's gonna help me on YouTube and it's gonna show the video to more people. And if you haven't seen this video, please check it out. And until I see you next time, I hope you are gonna have some happy moments on your GrandMA3 programming journey. Thank you.